So I was on set as for some of the scenes, especially you facing off against Brian.
Right.
And there seemed to be two things.
Oh, number you were for me facing off against Brian. Was I sick that day? Did we talk?
You guys, well, I remember we got you and Jessica at about 11 o'clock at night.
Oh, I remember. Yeah, I remember.
It seemed like that was filled with two things, which was a lot of rain and a lot of hanging around in harnesses. So
yeah.
Which is worse, rain or harness?
Which is worse, harness? There's a thing that takes place. The harness is worse at the start, and then you begin to get used to wearing it. The rain is delightful at the start, and then it becomes a fucking drag over time. You know, it's sweet because people come up in between takes with a towel, but you're wearing clothes that's drenched, and you can't, you know, so it doesn't even.
Yeah.
You know, but they were nice enough. They put in and I asked for electric heater, so they had an electric heater on.
Mm-hmm.
Had the fucking air conditioner nearly killed me, though. That was the thing as well. They had the air conditioner on, you know, and I said, can we turn off the air conditioner, please, in this 50,000 square foot studio?
Yeah. It's.
But I would go with that. So my answer is, being Irish, I love the rain.
Okay.
Because I don't live there anymore. I love the rain. If I was Irish and lived in Ireland, I'd have to go. Because I'd hate the rain, because I'd be dealing with it every day. I go home to Dublin, and everyone gets so pissed off, because I go, oh, it's raining, it's beautiful, and they're like, fuck you, it's a Hollywood, and
I know
LA
feeling.
Sun. And
I know the feeling.
Do you live here?
I do.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so people argue when I laugh down the phone.
Because I do, I miss it, and so when I go home, because I only see it for...
I know the feeling.
Same, yeah.
Yeah, I like the clouds sometimes.
Same, man.
You're a fan of the original.
Mm-hmm.
Were you ever tempted to slip a little Arnie into your performance, just to...
Slip a little Arnie into me? Why don't you? No one ever asked me if I wanted to slip a little Arnie into me. No, was I? I don't think so. Arnie is just, you know, I remember him back in the day, you know, growing up. I mean, I watched all of his stuff and loved all of his films.
Yeah.
So, but I didn't even for fun, I didn't. I slipped more when I was doing Fright Night, which went for another remake. I slipped more in between takes Dracula into... I had fun pretending I was Dracula, like a 6-year-old in between takes.
Why not?
Why not, man? You're wearing fangs, you know. Exactly. When in Transylvania, do as Transylvanians.
You've got to act like that. It's the rule practically.
I think so. Yeah.
I talked to Jessica about this, but you're playing a character who basically has had his memory wiped and had another personality put on, and here's this woman that loves him and he loved before.
Mm-hmm.
Is it easier? Sort of playing that vibe and that note when you've only just met the person, you're kind of like, who the hell are you, and why should I be in love with you? Aside from the fact that you're Jessica Biel, and she's
man. And when I just met Jessica and I didn't know her, I mean, I don't know, because I don't think there's any kind of scientific certainties in acting and filmmaking. You know, you hear stories of on-screen couples that had amazing chemistry. Hating each other. You hear stories of the actors hating each other.
Mm-hmm.
And then I know of actors who really have wonderful chemistry in real life and love each other, and on screen it's flat as fuck. So, you know, it's weird. I don't know what way things work, but we worked fairly hard on talking about backstory and talking about when Quaid came into Melina's life, and because Quaid had such a change of heart, he crossed sides of the tracks totally, because Melina kind of exposed him to what the truth was in the world with regards to the resistance and Cohagan's political party, and so we spoke about that kind of stuff, and you know, it was interesting trying to figure out when, if in fact there is a moment that Quaid realizes that he loves Melina and remembers her somewhat, and maybe he doesn't even remember her so much intellectually or mentally. Maybe it's more of, you know, the feeling that he had for her comes back, and that was kind of what Len was going for the whole time.